Hey guys, welcome back to Tales from This Side. I'm Grey Wolf. Today we're going to be doing a storage building, because we've already done our starter house. So last time, we finished up the starter house, we got to kind of start a little baby farm here, and as I said, we're going to move forward a lot faster. So we're going to go ahead and make sure that we do at least one build in every episode is the plan. Well, I think it's about time that we get started. Thank you for coming again. Here we go. Hey guys, so what we're going to do is we've got to clear out some of the space so that we have room for the building. We're going to do it right there where the torch is. That's going to be the center-ish. And we're going to just clear out some of this spot. So that's kind of boring for you guys to watch. I'm going to go ahead and take care of that off camera. We'll come right back when it's finished. Hey guys, so kind of finishing up some of this touch-up of filling in. We've got the space cleared in between. Kind of like this, we'll probably clear out a little bit more, but it's got a nice view on the back side here, and I think this will be pretty good. As you can see, we kind of laid out the front area so that I can have an idea of where I wanted to put stuff. We're going to chop down a couple of these trees, and we're going to actually jump right into the building. Alright guys, so as you can see here, got everything cleared out. I think we're going to leave this a little bit here. But for the most part, we have the three pillars in the front, which gives me the width of the largest width that I want to see for the building. So we're going to go ahead and get ready to get started building. I think we're going to do we're definitely going to do the scaffolding first. I always do scaffolding. I do it by numbers, just counting over. So if you want to count with me, you're more than welcome to in the video. And all I'm doing is I'm placing down a single block, log usually for my scaffolding, and I put it in the place that I want so that I can kind of sketch out the rough outline of the building in my head. And I don't like them to be 100% even, so I like mixing them up quite a bit, and that's what I'm doing right now. Is I'm actually mixing the width, or the length coming back into the building. We're going to put one in the center here. I think that this is going to be a good start for a building. I'm kind of thinking like a modern day storage building mixed with maybe a medieval style look, so it has a really nice roof attached to it. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to kick you guys off into watching this in a time lapse, and I hope you enjoy the time. Hey guys, just slowing it down real quick. Just wanted everybody to be able to see what was going on. I know sometimes it's hard to see when it's blurring across the screen. We were getting ready to work on the wall scaffoldings for the sides, and we're going to get ready to start filling in our scaffolding here. So, hope you guys are enjoying. Here we go again. Alright guys, welcome back, and what you're seeing is that I'm adding a little bit of details in, and I like to add these details a little bit at a time, just so that I've got an understanding of, like, specifically where I want something to go, or maybe how I want it to look, and if I don't like it, I'll go ahead and switch it out. So as you can see, taking a look at each side, maybe we'll have the oak, maybe we'll have the spruce, and to be honest, I think I've made a decision, so we're gonna go ahead and replace it with the oak. in doing this, it allows me to see multiple things at one time, which can be really helpful. And when you can see those multiple things at one time, the way it's helpful is that you can decide, okay, I like this half, I don't like this half. And that makes it so that I don't necessarily have to come back later to readjust things. Now, if I like something a little bit better, that's how I'm going to do it still, because then I can just switch it over, okay? But as you can see here, we've got our stairs completed up, and you can see that we're working on the scaffolding. I'm going to start doing a little bit of an overhang here in the front, because I want this to be a nice, big, wide front door. I know that it's on hard, and yeah, we can have mobs chase us around. However, the aesthetics really matter to me. So I'm going to go ahead and do what I like to see, and what I like is maybe a big front door. Especially on a warehouse style building, maybe medieval, but it's still a warehouse style building is what I'm looking for. So we're going to have, you know, storage downstairs in the back, maybe an office up top with a little bit of a warming spot or a break spot. And this is how I'm thinking about it as I'm building it. So usually you're going to get those types of buildings to be big and square or rectangular. I do want to add a little bit of a touch to keep it in line with what we're currently working on, so I'm not going to make it 100% just a big flat building. However, what I do want to see is something that resembles that, that can be pulled into the world that we're creating. I really like this awning. I think that it gives it a nice kind of slight shift. We're gonna give up oak walls for now. And of course, you know, you gotta worry about windows and lighting. And when you're building, it's hard to worry about those things when you've got a dirt wall on the other side. So while you're building, you should be thinking about it. So when I'm running my scaffolding, I think about, like, how am I gonna do this? Now, as you can see, we finished the back room a little bit. I have not finished it completely. We still need to add more chests. We did do the flooring. And as you can see here, I'm just filling in the walls for now. I like where that hole is, so I'm gonna put a window there. We need to make sure that we have plenty of lighting. And I figured we'd have an up and a downside. Now up here is gonna be the break area. So we're gonna fill in the walls up here. And then I'm gonna come back. I might find a spot or two that I like putting a window, but I'm gonna come back. I also told you that I really like the view out the backside, so we're gonna leave a spot for a door in the back there. And that way we can get out to maybe a balcony or something that's on the backside. So I've ran out of the planks for the most part, so let's do a little bit of a balcony area. We don't want it too huge because I don't really want it to hang over the cliffside, but when you're standing on the balcony, maybe you shouldn't see where the cliffside ends, is what I'm thinking, unless you look like down. So I think that, you know, a couple blocks, maybe three blocks out would be great. So I think that that'll look okay. We'll come up with stairs because I do want it to come down. We're going to put maybe a different type of area down in the back because it can't always be raining outside. And a lot of places usually have a break area out back. So it's not necessarily going to be storage out back, but we do want something out here. I'm going to add this extra layer of trim that'll give it just something to pop from the walls. So we have the dark and the light on the flooring, and then I've chosen the oak, which is kind of a mid-tone between the two, as my walls. I think that that works out really well. As you can see here, we're going to come down a little bit because we're using slabs. We have to get that extra half a block down so that we can make it look supported by adding pillars. You know, I really like building like this. I think that it's very pleasing. I like the aesthetics of being able to build something that, you know, may not be real, may be real. I'm using a lot of inspiration from things that I know. So I have the ability to kind of build what I want to see in the world. I really, really like that. I think that it's absolutely gorgeous. No matter how many times we make mistakes, we can always go back and fix it. It's not like that always in the real world. However, a lot of the time, if you are doing the right thing, usually you can fix something that you've broken. Not always, but usually. And I think that that is nice. I think it's a good way to look at life. I personally believe that we can definitely get the the different pieces that we break, and if we don't like what we see, we can always remake it here. However, in Minecraft, it's a little bit different. You know, you can, it's literally something so wonderful and so easily replaced, and that's maybe why I find it so relaxing, is that I can fix or change pretty much anything. I mean, they even have shader packs, and they have, you know, texture packs and all of that. I find that nice. I think that's probably one of my biggest attractions to this game, is that, yet there's things, mobs, in it that can, you know, remove your stuff accidentally by you being too close, like a creeper. But I honestly believe that the fact that I can see what I want to see is beyond amazing. Sorry, kind of got off on a tangent there. I really appreciate the game for what it offers. And it offers a bit of freedom that you don't always get in real life, that's all. So we're going to start looking at where we're going to put our windows. I want to put in right here a couple of logs going up to make the door look supported. So we're going to add the logs in. And yeah, I like that, so I think that's going to stay. We're going to do the spruce because that way it matches at the top. We're going to switch this around to kind of give it a break in the middle of the log so that it doesn't look so plain all the way across. I like how it overhangs and you have to look down for what we want. We're going to go ahead and I think we're going to add we're going to start adding our roof now, and then we'll come back and we'll finish filling in when I get more material for those. Like I said, we kind of ran out. So we're going to start with the roof here. I'm going to get to chopping away, or adding away, I guess, into the roof. I'm going with the birch as the primary, like, portions of the roof on this side. I think that it would create a very good contrast, especially against the spruce that we already have, just like the floors. So I'm kind of choosing to go in a similar route as we did with our lower end floors here. Gotta cut that out. We're gonna add some full blocks in here, and yeah, I like that. So as you can see, I kind of added it up against the wall there too. It changes the entire texturing of the piece, so the upper portion, the walls, will be matched like this, and then across the very top, I believe we're gonna go with an oak, and then we're gonna do a stone outline, just like we did down with the awning. I might choose spruce just because it's an easier wood to get right now, and we can always come back and take care of it. So I think that that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go ahead and stop jibber jabbering for just a moment. We're going to go ahead and get back into watching this, and then we might actually jump into another time lapse. I'm not sure yet. I think that you guys like them, but we'll find out here soon enough. Alright, so I had to stop for a minute and grab some more materials. I really like what I'm seeing, and I hope that you guys are enjoying watching at least. So as you can see here, we're almost finished with scaffolding, got the lower floor on, we can see that we're starting the roof line. Now we're going to add in a little bit more details, but I got more materials, so we're going to go ahead and start on the walls, I believe. And as we come along with the walls, we'll go until we run out of material again, we have to wait for more trees to grow. And then I'll start working on other aspects inside the building. So I'm going to start by putting our wall in up front here, because it's going to be pretty much the largest wall we have. And I'm going to skip the spots where I know I wanted the windows, whether I wanted them, you know, big or small. I think I'm going to do a couple maybe different size windows, but with the spacing, I don't know if that's actually going to work. So I think our best bet is to maybe go with 2x. I want to make sure that they're even across the front. And we can back up and take a look at it from here in a second to see what we think. I think 3 windows are going to look really good. So let's cut these out. We'll do the upside down stairs. Wow, words are a thing, and they are very hard sometimes. So we're going to do upside down stone stairs. And that will be marking like the header of our windows. I'm not going to do a footer due to the fact that we're just running along the log. So we're going to back up, grab our goodies. And from the inside, I think that looks really good. So let's add to the wall on this side and see if we can get some more spots where natural light would come in. I try to think about it like we are really building that building in the real world. I'm going to fill in the wall first, and then I'm going to come back and put in where I think certain windows should go. But all we're trying to do is make sure that our walls are full the way we want to fill them. I'm going to finish that up real quick. Alright. Tree's finally green, so I got a bit more. So we're going to do the front here. We're going to fill it in. As you can see here, we're going to block up the trigger. So we're going to come up, and if you look in the center there, at the top, these pieces here, I think that because we want to create a flush wall there, or a wall that goes straight up and down, we're just going to add in some more of our oak, and then I'll cut out the windows that I want to see there, kind of adding light to the upstairs portion. If you've ever been in a warehouse, you'll see that they do a lot of windows for light, not necessarily for you to see out of. And I think that that is an aesthetic that we need to make sure that we add into our storage building here due to that. Okay, well, I trapped myself in my seat. Oh, nope, didn't make it. Alright, so from there, we're going to cut out the other side here. I think two by two window would be perfect up here, as if they're large windows to be able to get enough light in the upstairs so that when people are on break they can see the light. Let's finish up these walls. We'll come back. We'll clear out a window as we feel that they need to be there. So right here, kind of, and we'll add one here because that block is actually just a temporary block for me to come up and down. So when we rip it out, it'll look like it's an actual one block window. So from here, we're going to get some slabs, some fences, and that way we can add the bits of detail, bits and bobs that we want to see for the interior so that nobody's falling off. So we're going to make sure to finish up the wall on this side first before we put in the fence that's going to be in the way. And the fences, I think, should be a brighter color. Not always should they be. You don't really have to. You can put in walls here. You can do anything that you want to see. But I think that it leaves it in an open space so that it feels much larger than it really is. I like that a lot. So we're going to go up on top. And we're going to just go ahead and start dragging things across. This, unfortunately, I think we'll change out the color later on because we don't have enough of the oak to complete what I wanted to complete. So as we come all the way across, it'll give us the interior portion of the upper roof, and then we'll come around the outside with a bit of an awning area. Or an overhang. An overhang, that's what I'm looking for. So we'll finish up the other portion with an overhang. And we'll see. I'm pretty sure that this is the level I want it to go, because the next roof will actually change angles to be a bit steeper. And I think that that'll cause enough for the break up there. So we're going to cut into another time lapse so you guys don't have to watch me tearing up the flooring or any of the other bits. We'll come back at the end and we'll just kind of maybe do a walkthrough this time to look over what it looks like when we get to the finish point. So I think from here we're going to go ahead and get started with our time lapse. Hope you guys enjoy it again.
Promise you ever, man.
Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed the time lapse. Look, as you can see behind me, we're finished up with some of the details for now. We'll take a look at it real quick. So as you see, we got the shutters and we've got the awnings, and I put in a little bit of an awning over the windows. We got barrels at the bottom here. I think those add a really nice touch. We've got our windows that are covered in brush. I figured it'd kind of feel like it's an overgrown area. Not necessarily that it's not taken care of, but intentionally overgrown. And as you can see here, we added some of the stripped oak. Let's get a better look on the inside. So on the sides here, you can see the stripped oak. We've texturized the bottom portion for the most part. We have the stripped oak at top. I think that just adds a nice change in variation in the texturing, but keeping it roughly the same color. As you can see, the windows up here actually don't go to the outside. So what I did was kind of make them like vent holes or windows that just run into the top there for aesthetics. We got our windows at our back here. And I love the way the floor has turned out. I'm using all three, so we used one for the stairs and then two for the floor. It's gorgeous. In the back here, this is actually the storage room. So we've got all of our storage set up. This nice pillar in between. Maybe we can add some more storage beside that. But it's plenty of storage for now. Good amount of storage for starting. We've got the upside downstairs. And I think that creates like a little vent hole there. At least in my opinion, it looks pretty good. So as you can see, we're symmetrical on both sides. We're gonna go out back and take a look at this beautiful view. Now out here, instead of using the birch fences, we used oak going down because it felt more weathered. In the back here, we've got a path in the back. I don't know what I wanna add. I thought about maybe originally adding a door, maybe like a back door, but we have one upstairs. So I think we can add a little something here. Maybe you guys can let me know in the comments. I think this is absolutely one of my favorite views for a build that I've done so far. I think that is something that I wanted to see, and I really enjoyed the aesthetics of this. As you can see there, we put the button on the back so that we didn't have to see anything. So that kind of comes to the end here. We're running out of time. I hope you enjoyed the video. We'll see you next week. And please remember to like and subscribe. Also, as usual, love me, hate me, let me know down in the comments. We'll see you again next time, and until next week, be safe out there. Bye.